Hi and welcome back to Power Electronics Lectures. In today's lecture, we'll talk about the diode reverse recovery characteristics, how the diode will operate and behave when it's connected in series or in parallel within the circuit. And then we'll talk briefly about the switch diode circuits when it's connected to a circuit with RLC load or RC load and so on and so forth. So let's study the reverse recovery characteristics for the diode. The reverse recovery characteristic for the diode depends largely on the depletion region in a p-n junction. We know in a p-n junction, in the depletion region here, if the diode is not connected to any external voltage source, we have mobile charge carriers, but these mobile charge carriers are not exist in the depletion region. When the diode is connected to an external voltage source, so we expect that there is current flowing inside this diode. But when we remove the external voltage source, or if we have no current flowing within the circuit, so the current inside the diode starts falling to zero. But this fall down current does not happen immediately. It takes time because within the depletion region, the free charge carrier takes time to bias either to the negative or the positive side material. So let's draw the curve of the current here. So let's say this is the diode current ID, and here we have the time, and we suppose that the diode is in the on state. At this moment, the diode is on. If we happen to switch off the diode, what's happening at that moment? The current will start falling down to zero. And this falling down action takes time. The problem is that the current will also start flowing in the opposite direction. So it will take time to flow in the opposite direction. Then after that, it will start recovering to reach to zero or very close to zero. The total recovery time is defined from this point when the current hit the zero line. To approximately 25% of the peak current in the opposite direction. How the voltage behave in this case? When the diode is on, so we have a very small, very tiny voltage. We call this voltage is the forward voltage. This forward voltage, we hope that this voltage is zero, but the case is not like this. So when the diode is off, this voltage starts to falling and became the breakdown voltage, not the breakdown voltage, the voltage that is applied on the circuit. And here we have some oscillations till this voltage reach to its steady state value. So here we reach the maximum. Near VD. So again, this is the reverse recovery time. Reverse recovery time. And this reverse recovery time is divided into two times, the time from the zero crossing to the peak current, okay, and the time from here to here from the peak current occurs to 25% of that current, or when this current reached to zero. This time, let's say this is TA, depends on the charge storage in the depletion region of the junction. And this time here, TB, let's say, this depends on the charge storage in the bulk semiconductor material. Anyhow, the total recovery time is from here to here. And this area here represents the reverse recovery charge. Reverse recovery charge. And this reverse recovery charge can be calculated by this equation. Q is the charge, is equal to half of the current times the time period. The current is equal to IR, maximum here, and the time period is the TR. Okay. From this slope, we can find a relation between time and the current and the rate of change of this current. So this can be defined as IR is equal to how much? This time TA times the rate of change of this current. And usually this TA is way larger or longer than TB, and most of the time we can neglect TB and replace it with TA if we want. So we can say that TA is almost equal to TR, the reverse recovery time. Okay. Again, this equation comes from, like when we say that di by dt, the rate of change of the current is equal to how much? The current IR over the time period. The maximum current is IR, the maximum time is TA. And from this we can say IR is equal to TA times di by dt. Okay? Types of power diodes. Power diodes can be divided into three main diodes. Number one is the standard diode or the general purpose diode. Number two is the fast recovery diode. And number three is the Schottky diodes. Every one of these diodes has specific characteristics. For example, the general purpose diode, you'll find that this diode can tolerate high voltage and high current levels. Like you can say that this diode can operate with 6,000 up to 6,000 volt and up to 4,500 amperes. For the fast recovery diode, you will find that this diode can also be operating up to 6,000 volts, but the current rating will be within the 1,000 amperes range. But the difference between the fast recovery diodes and the general purpose is that the recovery time for the fast recovery diodes, of course, much smaller than the recovery time of the general purpose diode. You'll find that the recovery time can be ranged from 0.1 microsecond to 5 microsecond. Now let me explain something here. When we talk about recovery time 5 microseconds, the 5 microseconds means in hertz how much? 1 over 5 microseconds is equal to how much? 200 kilohertz. So if we want to operate a power converter that uses 200 kilohertz switching frequency, so this converter will be what? Will be spending all of the time in the recovery mode. So 5 microseconds, of course, is not suitable for 200 kilohertz converters or switching time. So if we have a diode or transistor or device that has 5 microsecond recovery time, so this can be operating at maybe 20 kilohertz or 10 kilohertz, not more than this. For the Schottky diode, you'll find that this type of diode has a very low on state voltage. And very small recovery time. That's very nice, no problems. But the problem of this Schottky diode is that this kind of diode has high leakage current. If it's compared with other types of diodes, like the fast recovery diodes and the general purpose diodes. So we have trade-off. If you are looking for high frequency applications, then of course we need to use fast recovery diodes. If the main purpose of our design is the high voltage, high current, so the general purpose diode is fine, no problems, because it can operate at high voltage, high current. If we care much about the low on-state voltage and the small recovery time, and we don't care much about the leakage current, or maybe if the current that we use in the converter is very small, so that's fine. We can use the Schottky diodes at that moment. As we explained previously, we know that silicon carbide is a new material for power electronics systems, and we think that it's a great potential that can greatly replace the silicon devices. Silicon carbide diodes have an ultra power losses and high reliability. And they also have many nice features, like the reverse current for these diodes are very small or very tiny. It can be negligible. And also they have ultra-fast switching behavior, so they are very fast. And also there is no temperature influence on the switching behavior, because, as we said, they have almost no losses or very small losses. If we try to write or to compare the curves for these diodes, Here, for example, we talked about the silicon diodes. This is ID, the diode current. And here is the forward current. And we said we have something like this for the silicon diodes. For the silicon carbide, we have the same behavior on the forward bias. And when this fold down, you'll find that we have a very small leakage current and very small reverse current here compared to this value. So here is the silicon carbide diodes. The typical storage charge for silicon carbide diode is equal to 21 nanocoulomb for 600 volt and 6 amperes diode. And if you talk about 600 volts and 10 amperes diode, so this value will not be changed much, so the charge will be around 23 nanocoulomb. So that's a really nice feature for silicon carbide materials. This small reverse recovery current has loads of advantages in saving energy in many applications, such as PV inverters, power supplies, onboard chargers and transportations, wind turbines applications. Also, this feature has a very important or has a significant advantage in electromagnetic interference in many applications. Next time, we will talk about the connection of the diode, the series connection, the parallel connection. We'll see if we have two diodes from different manufacturers. Will that make any difference if we connect these diodes in a circuit, either in series or parallel? We'll see that in the full lecture, and see you next time.